Here's the thing, guys. I don't really think that you should be subscribed to one AI model, whether that's ChatGPT, Claude, or Gemini. I really think that you are better off not paying for one of them. And in this video, I'm gonna tell you why. Let me preface that by saying that this video is for those AI enthusiasts, those people who really wanna get all the juice out of their language models, who really want to get into prompt engineering and making the most out of AI. So if you're one of them, welcome, stick around, because I'm gonna tell you exactly what do I mean right now. In fact, I think that you should not pay for one AI model. I think you should pay for all of them or none of them. And let's get into the why. If you look at my screen right now, we're looking at the pricing for ChatGPT. Now, you're pretty familiar with this, and it's about $20 per month for the plus version, which is what most people are using nowadays. Then we have Gemini, which is about the same. However, the prices for me right now are in local currency. It's about 15 bucks. Then you have Claude right here for about $17 monthly. So you can see that the pricing are pretty similar for all of them. Now, I just told you that you're better off not subscribing to one of them, but instead subscribing to all or none. And the reason for that is that if you're really into prompt engineering and getting the best answer that you can, you have to, but let me repeat that, you have to test your prompts with all models at the same time. And you have to do that constantly. So if you're working on a content creation prompt, you want to see what output you get from Gemini, you want to see what output you get from Claude and from ChatGPT. And then you're going to quickly identify, oh, this prompt works better with Claude or works better with ChatGPT. So if you need to have access to the three models, what are you going to do? Of course, you could be paying about $60 plus monthly, but that's not my preference. In fact, what I would advise you to do is to go ahead and get the API keys for each of those models. So this is my API key for ChatGPT, so for OpenAI. I've been creating API keys for a long time, since the model came out, in fact. And what you do with an API key is you just use any interface that you want. I'm going to show you my favorite one in a minute, but you can use any kind of interface or UX kind of experience to just use the API to call the model each time you need it. And that will make you to essentially pay as you go. Now, if you know how much the tokens for these models cost, you'll know that it's pretty likely that you'll stay under the $20 mark per month if you're a regular kind of user. Now, if you're dealing with multiple large files, like you're, I don't know, uploading books and PDFs that are like hundreds of pages, then okay, maybe you're better off with a $20 subscription. But those are really niche cases and particular scenarios. So let's say you follow my advice here and you decide to either get the three subscriptions of the models or you get the three APIs that you need, like I just did. And I'm not gonna tell you how to get the APIs because you can easily Google that and get the answer on how to get the API keys for Gemini, Claude, and of course, ChatGPT. It's so simple. But once you get all of them, the next step is to find a platform that allows you to test the three models at once. Now, there's a ton out there, but some of my favorite ones are Prompt Hub, right here, which is essentially a kind of a prompt management platform, but that also allows you to compare the models as they go. And my favorite one, it's TypingMind. I've been recommending TypingMind as an interface because it allows you to do a ton of stuff, but most importantly, it's a one-time purchase of about $35 to $40, I think, even less nowadays. And you can just do a ton of things with it. Once you have all of your API keys for all your models, you're gonna go ahead and put them inside of TypingMind. Everything is stored locally, so no problem there. You're gonna have total security with your API keys. And then when you open a chat interface like this one, you're gonna see that you can select your model right here. So just like you can do that in ChatGPT, you can select between GPT 4.5 or 4.0 or 4.1. You can do the same thing here. You just select whatever model out of the Gemini models, the ChatGPT models, and you got some of the Claude models as well here. But the magic here is in actually clicking the plus icon so you can do multi-model. So just as you can see here, I've selected Gemini 2.5 Flash, GPT 4.1, and Claude Sonnet 4. And Claude is my favorite out of all these models, by the way, but just saying. Okay, so now that you have all of them selected, here's where the magic happens. I'm gonna use a prompt that I have saved right here and then click send. So basically we have all three models working in tandem here to give us an answer. Now you see Gemini Flash, which is the fastest model, already kind of having an answer for us, and it's creating this table that I told it to create. This is pretty awesome, and you can see that then we have ChatGPT as usual, and then we will have Claude, which is taking its time as usual. Now, you can see that this is kind of what I mean with comparing the answers, right? You will see that each one of them will give you different answers to one prompt, and this is just the habit that you need to create as a prompt engineer. You need to compare the outputs out of different models, and of course you're not going to do this with 10 models, but you're going to do it with the top 3 models that you like, or yeah, something like that essentially. You can then keep the conversation going, you know, continue to refine this prompt, see which model gets it together, and then create essentially a repeatable process that you can know and trust in this specific prompt with this specific model. Okay, so let's quickly recap here. If you don't want to pay for the 3 subscriptions, meaning ChatGPT, Claude, and Gemini, then go ahead and get the API keys for each one of those and go to a pay-as-you-go model. Then you will go ahead and find your favorite interface to use with those APIs. We have TypingMind, which is my favorite. I'm gonna leave that link down below. And you also have Prompt Hub and many, many others. Many other applications that allow you to use the API keys, by the way. Anyways, start thinking like an AI prompt engineer and test your prompts with the 3 models in tandem. Once you do that and you see what big differences they make, you will be on your way to actually selecting the best model for each use case. And then, my friends, the whole game changes. And speaking of AI applications that will totally change the game, if you want to know what my favorite task manager is, go ahead, click that video up there. And if not, I'll see you in the next video, guys. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe. Bye-bye.